Hey, look, Larry. Look at this. It's an Indian headquarter. That's got to be worth a fortune.
Chris, there's no Indian headquarters. That's George Washington.
Okay, Mr. Numismatic, then explain the headdress.
It's a ponytail.
Oh, wow. Well, this has to be rare, then. George Washington dressed up as a woman.
Here.
Look at this, Larry. It's an old Playboy magazine. You know what, buddy? This is a little gift from me to you, because you're married to Sharon, and you probably need it a little more than I do.
I knew it. Here it is. The Beatles did do Hey Jude.
Pay up. Jeez, I could have sworn it was Peter and Gordon. What's this? Look, Larry. It's a picture of me as a baby with a couple of pilgrims.
Chris, they're not pilgrims. They're Amish.
Amish? Well, I don't ever remember meeting any Amish people when I was one. What else is in here?
Just a couple pictures and this, a receipt.
Let me see this. One baby boy, Emmett. 10-0-0-0. Larry. Larry, do you know what this means?
No, but I have a feeling you have some stupid theory.
Larry, all the pieces of the puzzle are there. Put them together. And it's not one of those difficult puzzles either, like the kitten with the marbles.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that the Petersons bought me from an Amish couple for $10,000 on the black market.
That can't be right.
Larry, it all makes sense. That's why I don't have any brothers or any sisters. They were too cheap to buy anymore. But Larry, look. Look at Daddy. I'm his spitting image.
Chris, you look nothing like this guy.
Well, come on, you make his beard a little blonder, you take away the black on stylish clothing, give him some snappy sportswear from Banana Republic, and you got me.
Chris, this is crazy.
I'm not Chris. I'm Emmett. A healthy white Amish baby sold to a couple of two-bit carpetbaggers. Larry, I'm adopted. Hold me. I finally know the truth, Mr. and Mrs. Peterson.
I know I'm going to regret this question, Gladys, but just what do you mean by that, Chris?
Well, for openers, you're not my real mother and father.
Okay, for closes, then.
How cavalier, how laissez-faire, how plucky-plock.
Honey, we'd never be plucky-plock with you.
Oh, Ma, you don't have to put up a front for me any longer. Those days are gone, long forgotten. Like my size 4 underpants. I now know the hideous, ugly, tragic truth.
What the hell are you talking about?
I found out that I'm adopted.
Are you nuts, boy?
Oh, don't try to deny it, Mr. Peterson. It's obvious we look nothing alike.
Oh, you gotta be kidding. For better or worse, we're mirror images.
Oh, yeah, I believe that. And I guess Scott Thorson was born looking exactly like Liberace. Look, it's obvious that you've had extensive plastic surgery to make yourself look more like me. God, Dad, that's fiendish.
Chris, haven't we warned you to always crack a window when you use magic markers?
I don't know why I'm even talking to you. You're my landlord. Our conversations should be limited to stuff like, here's my rent check, sir. My sink is still broken. Good morrow to you.
Chris, don't be an ass. We're your parents.
Lying is only gonna make it worse, Ma. But then again, I guess my whole life has been a lie, hasn't it? All that matters now is that you admit it. Come on, Dad. Be a man. Admit it.
Dear, there's nothing to admit.
To Emmett? Emmett. You just called me Emmett. No, you did. I heard you. I heard Emmett, clear as a bell. You called me Emmett. After all these years, you finally let your guard down. I can't believe it. Oh, I'm suddenly so disoriented. Everything seems alien to me. Oh.
You're just a little goofy because you have an empty stomach. Why don't I fix you a sandwich?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I'm not allowed to take lunch from strangers. I think I know what has to be done now. Thanks for 30 years of shelter, clothing, and 3 square meals a day of lies.
Gladys, unless you think I should be concerned about this, I think I'll go take a nap.
Pleasant dreams, dear.
Why don't you just use a suitcase, Chris?
For the last time, I'm not Chris, I'm Emmett. And I have to travel all the way to the Pennsylvania Dutch country to be reunited with my natural Amish parents. But until that time, I must carry all my belongings in a simple handkerchief tied to a stick. For at this point, I am nothing but a lowly bastard hobo. Comprende?
It's ironic that your Spanish was the most decipherable thing in that whole speech.
Chris, I can't believe you're going through with this.
Larry, I have no choice. I can't rest until I'm reunited with my true parents in my ancestral homeland.
The Petersons are your true parents. I'm 99.9% sure of that.
Yeah, but it's that 0.2-thirds that's sending me back to the boonies.
This is a crazy thought. Forgive my wild imagination, but has it ever occurred to you that perhaps you're wrong?
Well, yeah, actually, that did occur to me. But when I confronted Fred and what's-her-name, they just denied it. Which is exactly what guilty people do when they sweep adopted dirt underneath the rug. But you know, I don't know why I'm telling you this. Because technically, you're not even my friend. You're actually Chris Peterson's friend. Geez, I wonder how many other friends they have on the payroll.
That's an insult. I wouldn't be your friend for any amount of money.
Well, that wasn't exactly phrased right, but you get the point.
Well, whatever. I'm off to the Pennsylvania Dutch country. And please, don't try to stop me. And whatever you do, do not tell Fred and Gladys, because it would destroy them. They've grown fond of this charade called Chris Peterson.
Well, don't you think they'll notice that you're missing?
Not for the first couple of weeks. Besides, they just try to track me down and buy me back. Everything is money with those people. So promise, okay?
Okay, I promise.
No. Look, if you're ever near the Pennsylvania Dutch country, why don't you look me up?
Do you even know where the Pennsylvania Dutch country is?
Well, not exactly. I have a feeling it's somewhere near the troubled Gaza Strip. I'll find it. Mama, Emmett's home.
I wonder what's keeping Chris. I put his breakfast down this morning and it's getting cold.
Oh, he's probably off watching a miniseries someplace.
Hello? Mr. and Mrs. Peterson?
Hi. I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Well, yeah, Larry. Gladys and I were just sitting here trying to figure how to get the bugs out of the Hubble telescope.
Mr. Peterson, you always crack me up.
It's nice to see you, Larry. What's new?
Is your old man still running around with that redhead?
Fred.
Mr. and Mrs. Peterson, do you know how it is when you have a terrible secret gnawing at you?
No.
And you've got to tell somebody?
Fred and I have lots of horrible secrets we keep from each other.
That's right. I don't mind a bit. I got a few that would knock her socks off.
God, I can't take it anymore. I'm racked with guilt.
Larry, did Chris ever mention our short attention span?
It's just that he made me promise not to tell you.
Not to tell us what?
Yeah, out with it, boy. Come on.
Okay, okay, you've broken me. He's run away from home.
Can you do that when you're 30?
Can you have a paper route when you're 30?
Hey, don't make me get up from this table.
Why would Chris run away from home?
To find his real parents. He thinks he's been adopted.
I thought we cleared that up.
Yes, that's not one of our horrible secrets.
What about the picture of him with the Amish couple?
What the hell's he talking about?
You know, the picture of Chris as a baby being held by an Amish couple. He found it in the attic.
So what? We've also got a picture of him with Santa Claus.
That must be from our vacation in the Pennsylvania Dutch country.
Yeah, that's right. We went there when the health department closed down reptile land.
And we took a picture of him with an Amish couple, even though it was against every fiber of their religious beliefs.
Yeah, they probably got thrown in the hole for it.
I guess. You guys took a vacation to Pennsylvania Dutch country when Chris was a baby and took a souvenir picture of him with an Amish couple.
Nice work. Make some mantel space for that Nobel.
Oh, no. Now Chris has gone off to find some strangers and we're never going to see him again.
I wouldn't hold my breath.
But Mr. Peterson, don't you understand? You've got to go find him and bring him back.
Look, boy, the only thing I've got to do is die and pay taxes.
Oh, Fred, spare us the tired old cliches. Put on your street shoes. We're going to get our Chris back.
Mama, we've been standing out here staring at each other for 10 minutes. Aren't you gonna invite me in? I mean, you know, this is my home now, too.
Marta? Who goes?
Papa? Is that you? Oh, my God, of course it's you. What am I saying? The resemblance in the eyes is uncanny. Of course, I have a little different taste in clothing, but, you know, that's my generation. Hi. Hi.
Who are you?
Well, don't you recognize me? I'm your long-lost son, Emmett, and I finally come home.
What do you want from us?
Well, I want what we once had, one big happy family. And my dream has come true. We're all back together again.
Reunited, and it feels so good.
What a touching moment. So, what do you say we all come inside, shoot the bull, and throw back some brews?
Oh, my. Wow.
A disturbed city dweller. We had better humor him, or he may attack us.
Geez, everything's so plain and unfancy. You know, there's a new word. It's called color. You might want to put that one in your Rolodex. Gee, so you got 10 grand for me and you still live like this? What, do you guys have a gambling problem or something?
We are simple people, farmers.
Oh, well, that's great. That's perfect. I'll fit in fine. I'm simple, too. You know, I had a heck of a time finding you guys. The traffic out there is just horrendous. It was, bridle to bridle. Oh, my. Hey, what are we doing standing around gabbing? Star Trek The Next Generation is on in about 5 minutes.
I don't know what you speak.
Well, you know, where's your home entertainment center? Your big screen TV slash stereo slash waffle maker slash dealy slash thing.
All we have is a fireplace and a loom.
Whew, wow, party. Okay. Gosh, you guys are worse off than I thought. But don't worry, your luck has changed. The people you sold me to were very good to me, and I've returned home as your sugar daddy. Now hold on to your bonnets. I'm gonna bring you into the 20th century. Now where would that be? Huh. It's gotta be around here somewhere. Hey, Dad, where's the outlet?
We have no electricity.
Are you kidding? Did they shut it off? Jeez. You know, you really gotta watch that kind of stuff, because that could end up on your TRW. That's a credit report, Mom. Women. You know, when it comes to money, it's like they're on another planet. Oh. Hey, what's wrong with you two? Come on, this is supposed to be a joyous occasion. Your son Emmett is home. Put on your happy faces. That's better. Mom,
I've got a little surprise for you. It's a gay scarf.
Now, don't faint. Pierre Cardin.
See, all you had to do was accessorize a little bit.
We are humble folk. We shun the ways of the outside world. That is the custom of our people.
Oh. Oh, geez. Well, I guess if I'm going to live here, I guess I ought to accept your humble, simple ways. Sure, I'm going to miss my water pick. I guess something tells me, though, I won't be running into Claudia Schiffer at the supermarket, if you know what I mean.
Still sleeps?
Yes.
Now would be a good time to murder him. Only our religion did not forbid it.
If only.
Good morning. Good morning. Oh, I hope you don't mind. I found these clothes upstairs and I just kind of threw them on. I look nice and plain, don't I? Like a sexy young Amish lad. Well, it's 5:30 a.m. and everybody's up, hippity-hoppity, pippity-poppity. What, do you guys all have paper routes here or something?
Sir, if we fed you, would you leave us?
No. No, of course not. You're so insecure. No, I'm here forever. I'll get it, Papa. Fred, Gladys.
Oh, no, more of them.
What are you doing here?
We've come to take you home, you idiot.
This is now my home.
Couldn't you run away to a place like Florida or something? Say, do you have a TV around here? Brigitte Nielsen's going to be on the Today Show.
We do not have Faust Electronics. We are simple people, and we shun the ways of your people with your pre-sweetened cereals and your silent dog whistles. So be gone, you hedonistic, button-pushing, fancy pants.
Nice to know he hasn't changed.
Chris, I must admit you look very smart in a hat.
For the last time, I am not Chris. I am Emmett Stultzfoots, son to Jedediah and Martha Stultzfoots. We're the Stultzfootses. Yeah, tell him I'm your son. Come on.
But you're not our son.
So you bought their silence, too, huh? Like you buy everything else with your filthy money.
What money?
Like the $10,000 you paid for me on the black market.
Are you nuts? I never had $10,000 in my life.
Don't deny it. I have the receipt right here. Look at this. One baby boy, Emmett, $10,000.
What? One baby bonnet. $10.
That's the receipt from the Amish baby bonnet we bought for you years ago. And this must be the nice Amish couple we bought it from. We even took a picture of you with them.
I told you no good could come from being photographed.
I'm so embarrassed. I don't know what to say. This is worse than when I was sleepwalking through the neighborhood in my mom's robe.
Can we get the hell out of here now?
Wait a second, Dad. Not so fast. You know, I'm a little torn here. I mean, you two have been my parents for the last 15 hours, and I can't throw that away. You know, there's a bond that happens between a mother and a child, and that bond can never be broken. How I love you so dearly.
Maybe we could work out a 6-month exchange program?
No.
Well, then I guess this is goodbye. Papa, I want you to know that your simple ways will always be a part of me. But to be honest, I never had the cheekbones to carry off that cute beard without a mustache look anyway. And Mama, you know, I never did taste your meat, kraut, hash, sauerbraten pies, but, you know, I don't really like those heavy Italian sauces, and actually, they don't like me either.
You know what I mean.
So I guess as E.T. used to say, and we'll be right there.
Chris, they're Amish. They probably haven't seen a movie since Spartacus.
Sorry. Well, I'll miss you both dearly. Hey, listen, do you mind if I keep this outfit? My skin just kind of comes alive in black.
Take whatever you want. Just get out. I mean that in the most Christian sense.
I'm sorry if Chris has been a lot of trouble to you. You know how kids are. You have any of your own?
Yeah, but they're all married and on their own. That is the way with our people.
Well, normally, that's the way of our people, too, but...
Yeah, but then we'd be gypped out of precious moments like these. Hey, you know, since this is kind of, well, kind of a backward sort of family reunion of sorts, what do you say we get one of those Where Are They Now pictures, huh? What a great idea. Hey, Pop. Why don't you do the honors?
Oh, jeez.
There you go. Now, let's do this just like the other one. And I think in the other one, you were actually holding me, Papa, too. Oh, great. Okay.
Now can we please go?
Sure. Wait. Hold on a second here. Dad, if I'm not adopted, could you please explain this to me?
Oh, Chris, we just took that picture a second ago.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, I forgot. I love you guys. Oh, my.